Shalom. This is the territorial commander signing in. Prophet Mandla Khuzwayo, the man of fire. It's a Friday. You know how we do these things. Friday definitely is giving during lockdown. Without any further ado, let's go straight into the word of God. We are reading from the book of John, chapter number 4, verse number 7 and verse number 10. Verse number 7 reads, "There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus said unto her, Give me to drink." I want you to underline that little phrase, "Give me to drink." Verse number 10. "Jesus answered and said unto her, If thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith unto thee, Give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water." If you knew the gift of God, you would have asked me to give you living water. Son and daughter of the prophet, it's giving during lockdown. There is something very interesting here that caught my attention as I was going through the word of God. The Bible says that this is Jesus. He wants to spark, he wants to start a revival in the city of Samaria. And the Bible says that he's going to sit by the well because he's going to plant the seed of the word of God in the life of a woman. This woman is going to be used as a vessel or as a vehicle that is going to carry revival in Samaria because the Messiah finally has come to Samaria. But watch this. The Bible says as Jesus was sitting by the well, Jesus is going to test this woman because for this woman to receive this impartation, this gift, this grace, this privilege from Jesus of becoming the first evangelist in the city of Samaria, she must prove herself as a giver to Jesus first. Because you cannot receive from the hand of Jesus unless you first give to Jesus. So the Bible says Jesus sits at the well. Here comes this woman. As soon as she arrives at the well, she finds Jesus sitting there. Jesus realizes that this is the woman that I want to give the privilege of introducing the messianic anointing into the city of Samaria. No one has done that before. Jesus says to this woman, "Give me water to drink." The woman clearly does not understand the revelation behind giving. The Bible says that the woman looked at Jesus and said, "You know what? You are very funny. You are a Jew and I am a Samaritan. How can you ask me to give you water to drink? Because Samaritans and Jews, we don't share a thing." But what the woman does not understand is that the same Jesus who's asking her to give to him is carrying something far more important than this water that Jesus is asking for from this woman. Oh, she called it Prohofaka. In other words, whenever God says we must give, he understands that that which he wants us to give is not so much important than that which he wants to give to us. Imagine, this is just water. And Jesus makes it clear to this woman. Jesus says, "This water that you are denying me, this water that you are refusing to give to me, if you drink of this water today, you will be thirsty again. Tomorrow you'll have to come back here." Clearly, you don't understand who you are talking to and what is the gift of God. So if you knew who you are talking to and what is the gift of God, you would have asked me, Jesus, to give you water to drink. Because the water that I was going to give you was going to water that was going to give you eternal life. It was going to be living water, not this water that you are denying me. In other words, whenever God says, give your 10%, give your prophet's offering, give your free will offering, whenever God says to you, give your rental fund, or it doesn't matter your sacrifice, it doesn't matter what offering God is asking you to give. In other words, God has a bigger plan in mind, because there is no way that you are going to give to God and God does not give you something in return. And what he gives you is water, is living water. Whereas what he's asking you to give him is water that will quench your thirst only for that day. In other words, when God is asking for your 10%, that's nothing to God. Because the 10% that he's asking you to give him, it can run out anytime. if you're refusing to give it to him. But then once you release the 10% into his hand, what he's going to give you in return is going to be a generational wealth that is going to cover you and cover your children and cover your children's children. As the Bible says that a blessed man leaves an inheritance for his children's children. So in other words, if God says give to me, it's not a big deal. A lot of us, we're thinking, if I'm going to give and then I'm going to remain with nothing. Jesus says, if you only knew who you are talking to and what is the gift of God, you would have asked me to give you water. And the water that I was going to give you was going to be living water. Not this water that you drink today, you are thirsty tomorrow. So, son and daughter of the prophet, think about your finances. Think about the money. Think about your offering. If God can show up in your life now, just like he has sent me as a prophet, and he says, give to me. Imagine what you are missing out, what you are losing out on if you refuse to give to God. Because what he has in his hand is eternal, is living water, is eternal life. Listen to this. Giving will open you up to the prophetic. Jesus says, give to me. After he has said that, he started to prophesy over the life of this woman. So in other words, God, when you give to him, the prophetic way, the prophetic declaration that we keep declaring over your life, they will start opening up in your life and they will start finding expression in your life. They will be effective. That's what giving does. It opens you up to the prophetic. It opens you up to the angelic visitation. There is no way that God will say, Abraham, give to me, of which next week we are going to talk about this. There is no way that God will say, Abraham, give to me your son Isaac. And God is not waiting for you with something better than Isaac, the revelation of the Messiah on the mountain. So this woman almost lost out on her blessing because she refused to give Jesus just a little water that was going to quench the thirst of Jesus just for that day. Whereas Jesus, what he has in his hand is water, living water. Living water. Imagine, I pray for you as you go to the bank, as you make your deposit, as you pay your tithe, as you give a prophet's offering, as you pay your partnership, as you give your free will offering, your rental offering, whatever it is on these accounts or abonala screening up hands. May the God I serve visit your life, not just with water, not just with money, not just with a breakthrough that is going to last you for a day, but with a breakthrough that is living, that is eternal. Shalom. God bless you. This is a territorial commander signing out, the man of fire, Prophet Matla Khuzwayo. Enjoy this little bit of a clip that we lift up from church. We will see you. Please go to the bank and make that deposit. I call you blessed in Jesus' name.
Baba mangabukunikela unale miphumela oyishoyo ezwini lakho. Akubona kale kimi. Today I'm giving you the best. I'm giving you my best. I'm giving you the best. I'm giving you my best. I'm giving you the best. I'm giving you my best. Today I'm giving you the best. I'm giving you my best. If ukunikela kuyayenza lento ishoyo angikubone kimi. In Jesus' name. Amen. says he rebukes the devourer. Ukhuza okudlayo. Okwaziyo nongakwazi. By his power, he rebukes the devourer for our sake. And then he opens us windows of heaven and pull us out a blessing so that we won't have room enough to receive. And then he stands and says, silver and gold is mine. What type of a God is that God? He says, a kettle on the thousand hills are mine. I lack nothing. I own it all. I have it all. If I have to provide for you, I don't borrow from a neighbor and provide for you. I am a God who commands and boasts a rich reservoir of resources. As you are standing here to give your heart and money, you are not giving to man, but you are giving to the Almighty God. And he's gonna reward you and show up in your life. As you give your pay 10%, even those of you who gave it before, may Jehovah see you through in terms of how your kids are going to have their fees at school paid for. How your kids are going to have uniform and shoes and lunchbox and transport money. How your kids are going to be provided for. Your kids should look at you as a parent and say, I'm glad that my mother and my father, they serve a living God. And they are paying their tithe, securing our future. Just lift it up as I pray for you. And
I'm lost without you.
Meshi kanata kabe proteshi. Jesus, every envelope of 10% in the hand of everyone here, even the money paid electronically, I pray in the name of Jesus that the 90% that is still in their possession, stretch it, oh God, perform a miracle in their lives, provide for them from the first one in the corner there all the way to the last end, in the name of Jesus. Receive the anointing for financial prosperity and breakthrough. Take it in the name of Jesus. As I receive of your 10% in this realm, may Jehovah receive of your 10% up there and open you up windows of heaven and rebuke the devourer for your sake. I command you bless. I command you filled. In Jesus' name, may you never